Good morning, West Monroe. I'm Amaya, and I'm here with William, and we have your morning announcements.
Our number 2 ranked boys basketball team opens off playoff action at home tonight versus Thibodeau at 6 p.m. Student tickets can be purchased in the library during both lunch shifts on Thursday and Friday, which is today. The cost is $5. There are only 100 student tickets. Half-day seniors, you can buy your tickets in the library before leaving campus. Tickets at the door of the game will be $8.
Seniors, do not forget that scholarship applications for the Jason Paul Cameron Foundation are due to the guidance office by March 3rd.
Seniors, do not forget that scholarship applications for the Norman Education Fund scholarship is due April 2nd.
Also, seniors, do not forget to apply for ULM Foundation scholarships on the ULM Foundation Scholarship Portal.
Seniors, do not forget that applications for the Shelter Insurance Scholarship awarded by James Bradley Smith is due to guidance by March 30th.
Any girl interested in trying out for the girls' soccer team needs to go see Coach Barron in room 5203 to sign up. This is the last week to purchase your yearbook, so get yours at www.balfour.com.
Students, do not forget that if you are interested in joining the Louisiana Legislative Youth Advisory Council, you can access the application at civiced.louisiana.gov. The deadline to apply is March 26th.
If you can, re-request that everyone go vote for our West Monroe girls basketball team on KNOE Team of the Week. Also, congratulations to the girls basketball team on their third round win last night against Lafayette High School. The girls will be going to participate in the semifinal game at the state tournament next week. Girls, we are so, so proud of you.
Congrats to the girls and boys tennis team for defeating St. Fred Tuesday, defeating them 5-0. Congrats to the girls and boys tennis team for defeating Neville yesterday, defeating them 3-2. The winners were Chloe Batterton, Anna Claire Bannister, Braden Ernst, Noah Ferguson, Brooke McFarland,
Jeffrey Mann, Landry McNeely, Siv Patel, Graham Stevenson, Max Turpin, Gracie Zimick, with an overall win of 6-4. This week, February 22nd through 26th, is National FFA Week across the nation. Even with COVID, the ag classes have been busy learning, building, designing, and growing. Very soon, students will start looking at class opportunities for next year. Consider an ag-related class in your schedule for 2021-2022.
And before y'all go, here's a quick video about Black History Month.
Hi, my name is Robin Pierce. I'm an assistant principal at West Monroe High School.
Ms. Pierce, what is it like being a Black administrator?
Well, it's an honor, I'll say that, because it's one of few in this area, to be honest. But it's an honor for me. I'm proud of it because not only am I an influence on just Black females or Black males, also to young ladies. You know, they can look up to me and maybe aspire to do things that they see me do. So that's an honor. I take it seriously, actually.
Well, not to get personal, you know, people like to, you know. So where did you actually, like, grow up at?
I'm from Shreveport, actually. And actually, probably one of the roughest areas in Shreveport. In the hood, as you would. My brother was in a gang, the whole nine. So I've seen a lot of things, but I'm from Shreveport.
What advice would you give to a young Black woman?
To set your mind on goals and work hard to achieve them, and that you can be anything that you want to be. That, I mean, there's no limit. Look at Kamala Harris. I mean, right now, you know, here in 2021. So really and truly, just to reach for the stars and you can make it.
So I'm the one that's very goofy. So let me try to get out professional. But what was the funniest thing you ever done?
Ever done here at school or just period?
Just period.
Actually, probably I went to Southern University in Baton Rouge for a year before I moved up here. And some friends and I got together and we recorded a Push It video with salt and pepper. I mean, we had the green screen behind us. We did the dance, the whole nine. It was on a VHS. So that's probably one of the funniest things I think I can remember, at least from those times.
Why do you feel it's important to celebrate Black History Month?
Knowledge. I feel that knowledge is power. And so much in history period gets lost just in time. And especially for you youngsters, I feel that you need to be aware and knowledgeable, and you need to know not only about Black history, but just history itself. And I don't know if you've ever heard that oftentimes, you know, in order to avoid history repeating itself, we have to know about it, even though sometimes it still does. But that's why I feel it's very important. Knowledge is power.
Well, that was like all the questions we had to ask you, but is there anything else you want to say or want us to hear about?
I just want to encourage you guys and anyone else that's listening that you can do anything you set your mind to. Just don't give up. Thank y'all.
You're welcome.
And that's all we have for you today, West Monroe. Have a great day.